Chag Sameach, Tamidim and Tamidot. Now, why do I say Chag Sameach? I say Chag Sameach because I'm recording this video just as Tu B'Shvat is beginning. Now, the Gemara in Rosh Hashanah, on Daf Yud Aleph and Aleph, asks, Ve'echa B'Shvat Rosh Hashanah Le'ilan, my time, why is it that we celebrate Tu B'Shvat on this first day of Shvat, or as we celebrate it on the 15th, we call it Tu B'Shvat, obviously. So Gemara says, Amar Rabbi Lazar, Amar Bashaya, Alpha Pisha Rov Tkufa Mibachutz, Hoyo Vyotsu Barov Gishmi Shana. In effect, basically, the majority of the rain needed by the trees has already fallen, and the trees therefore prepare and begin to prepare for the spring. Now, the Gemara refers to it as Echad B'Shvat. That's based on a machlok between the Beisham and the Beis Hillel. Of course, we paskin that we celebrated on the 15th of the day. And it's fascinating that the 15th is chosen. The 15th, the same day that we choose for Pesach and for Sukkot, the same day that Kodesh Baruch Hu gives us in the Torah to celebrate these holidays. Why is the 15th such an incredibly symbolic day that we share all of these celebrations? And perhaps the answer is as simple as the 15th is a day that we have a full moon. The 15th is the brightest night of the month, where the moon gives off the greatest amount of light, creates clarity, sight, in an otherwise very dark environment. Maybe we celebrate the holiday of Pesach and Sukkot on the 15th because these chagim celebrate the redemption that occurred when HaKadosh Baruch Hu miraculously freed us from Mitzrayim and sustained us in the desert and created light in a dark world. We just read about Makar Choshech, in which the darkness was terrifying for the Mitzrim. The moon creates light, especially when it's full. And Tu B'Shvat is no different. Tu B'Shvat is celebrated in the dead of the winter, one of the coldest days of the years, perhaps, right in the middle. But you know what? Spring is coming. Trees, flowers, warm weather, it's on the way. That's the point of Tu B'Shvat, because Kodesh Baruch was telling us, have hope. We plant trees knowing that only our grandchildren, maybe great-grandchildren, maybe beyond, will benefit from it. Think of Jewish communities. Think of how they give tzedakah. Think of how they create endowments. It's all for the benefit of future generations. We give money to yeshivot. Sometimes that won't necessarily be able to use it or see it for decades to come. But we want to sustain these yeshivot. We want to keep them going. That's Tu B'Shvat. It's fascinating that the early Zionists in Israel, many of whom were completely secular, they didn't hold by Chazal, by the Gemara, by the Torah, but they celebrated Tu B'Shvat and they considered it to be one of the most significant, important days on the Jewish calendar because it represented hope for the future. As I mentioned, we want to hope as well. And that's why Tu B'Shvat is so impressively important, because of the fact that we recognize the concept that there's always light at the end of the tunnel. Spring is always right around the corner. Rabbi Jonathan Sacks, who I've been quoting a lot in recent weeks as we all try to cope with his passing, incredible, incredible, insightful individual, not enough could be said about him and his writings. But one of the things he wrote in Dignity of Difference, you can look it up, page 206. He wrote, one of the most important distinctions I have learned in the course of reflection on Jewish history is the difference between optimism and hope. Optimism is the belief that things will get better. Hope is the belief that together we can make things better. Optimism is a passive virtue, hope an active one. It takes no courage whatsoever to be an optimist, but it takes a great deal of courage to have hope. Knowing that we do our past, no Jew can be an optimist. But Jews have never, despite a history of sometimes awesome suffering, given up hope. Jews always hope. Tu B'Shvat is a chag of active hope in which we teach our children and grandchildren that we can never stop building the land of Israel. There are many times of darkness, cold, bitter days, but we have to have vision, motivation, drive, passion, stay motivated in the dread of the winter in order to create hope constantly. I say this at the heels of when COVID-19 is perhaps impacting us in the greatest way and to the greatest extent possible. And I recognize how dark it seems, but we have to remain hopeful. The vaccine is coming, and Emir Tzashem, we will all see this hope realized and actualized in a beautiful way. Chag Tu B'Shvat Sameach to all of you, and thank you for listening.